welcome to another action-packed movie minute. But Chris, we are in a very different location.
Yeah, we're not in a theater today.
This is very interesting. There's a lot of lights, very good lighting here. We are in the BCAN studio, pretty new here. You might have seen it in our other shows, like Arts Now, Daily Downtown.
Yeah. We thought we'd be cheap and just use the studio stuff.
Yeah, so save us some money. But Chris, we saw an awesome movie called
Searching. With John Cho in it and Deborah Messing. Oh my gosh.
Pretty thrilling, guys.
Yeah. Pretty thrilling.
So let's get right to it and get in the review.
I'm Margot.
I haven't been able to reach Margot. When was the last time you saw her?
The study group only went till 9.
I think we're gonna go late.
No, she definitely left at 9.
I'm Margot.
Did she mention anything unusual? Was she acting strange?
I'm Margot.
Where are you?
She's been transferring funds for the last 6 months.
I'm Margot.
We found blood in the vehicle.
How did David respond?
These problems usually start in the household.
Mr. Kim, is everything okay?
Everything is great. Margot and I are great.
She had cash in her car.
He felt bad about everything.
She was my best friend.
Oh my God.
Told me she ran away!
I didn't know her. I didn't know my daughter.
So that was a quick look at Searching, a movie that is kind of done in a really strange style,
yes.
Something that's a little new. It's told entirely through social media.
In the dad's perspective of social media, which,
yes.
Oh my gosh, this was a case for Neve from Catfish. Oh my gosh, Max and Neve. You taught Dave Kim everything that he knew, I swear. Like, if my parents were trying to find me on social media, they'd be like, password, oh, I don't know. We're done. Like, no, he was grade A detective.
Yes.
It was, yes. I was impressed. Yeah, yes. I thought it was great.
I mean, and for those of you who haven't seen anything about this movie, basically the premise is, John Cho, who plays David Kim in the movie, his daughter goes missing. And in order to help find her, he decides to go through her laptop and investigate her different social media accounts.
And it's all through the computer's perspective and
yes.
the phone's perspective,
yes.
which was a very interesting new type of style that they're doing with a lot of horror movies, thriller
yes.
movies. But it's really, it almost is sad though,
it's,
how much you can find on the internet about
right.
yourself and about people around you.
Right.
It's freaky.
A very timely message
yes.
with this movie, as far as, you know, how there's a difference between our real life personas and then our online personas.
Absolutely.
And you know, how much do you really know somebody
yes.
that's not, like, you know, outside of the online space? And I mean, it was a really interesting premise. I love the way they did the movie.
It was thrilling.
Yeah.
Twists and turns.
Very suspenseful.
I wasn't sure going into this because mm-hmm. like other movies that have kind of done this perspective, they did it okay. Mm-hmm. This kind of brought it to a whole new level, a new advantage of looking into someone else's life through their perspective. And it was very interesting. I think that Dave Kim, the father, he did a very amazing job just trying to figure out his own life along with his child. And these twists
yes.
in this film just threw
yes.
me,
it,
threw me off.
It definitely, it's a movie that keeps you on your toes.
Yes.
It was really great and really well acted. John Cho
yes.
did such a good job.
The dedicated, it was kind of
yes,
like Taken,
yes.
like the
yes.
dedicated father, but not so like,
Macho man.
Yeah, it was really good though.
And then Deborah Messing as the chief investigator for this, she did a fantastic job as well, I thought.
She was great.
Yes.
She was great.
Yeah, everybody in this movie did really well. It was really well done.
I don't think I have any grades.
No, Allie. I mean, Allie, what are you going to give this movie? Just, you know, rate it based on...
I think I'm going to give it a 4.8. I don't give it a perfect score just because at some points in the film, I think it would have been very well done to get more of the, I don't know, the first person was great for a lot of it, mm-hmm. but I think a third person perspective would have been also really good to just kind of splice in every here and there when it was needed. And I feel mm-hmm. almost maybe two times in the film, like right as it was getting to the turning point. I think it would have been really good to almost jump out of screen. So that's the only reason that I give it, but they did a great job with everything else. Oh, it was such a good thriller, twists and turns everywhere. I mean, you could watch it again and still maybe miss a few details and pieces. Chris, what do you give it?
I agree with you. This movie is really good. It was really well done. I would give this movie a 4.5.
Even lower.
Well,
I thought you really liked it.
You know, I just like to keep them at, you know, even like 0.5s. I like I know, to go by 0.5s.
I'm saving my 5.0 for like something spectacular, but so, this was really close. So it was hard.
This was really good. It was a really interesting, very unique movie. And honestly, if you haven't seen it yet, I suggest you go out and check this one out.
Yes, it's surprising a lot of people haven't been hearing about it. It hasn't been the rave right now, just because a few movies have been really big blockbusters. But this is a good underdog kind of a movie. It's really going to...
And it will definitely make you think twice about your kids' online presence.
Yes, scary enough. Delete your accounts.
I didn't know my daughter.
Well, there you have it. There is the action-packed movie minute review of Searching. Chris gave it a 4.5. I gave it a 4.8, saving the 5.0 for something great. But Searching was fantastic. Go out there and, you know,
check it out for yourself.
Check on your kids' social media.
Yeah.